Hi everyone, in today's video we're gonna see how to draw a heart on the oscilloscope using an Arduino controller. We will base our work on Lissajou curves, therefore we need the parametric equation of a heart. We'll code it into the Arduino and then view it on the oscilloscope. We'll start with a new Arduino sketch and we'll put the equations in it just so we remember them. This is the x equation. And this is the Y. I've modified the work of others to obtain the signals that I want, and I'll add their work in the description. We'll start by declaring the variables that we need. So we have the first wave, and it has it's an array of three. We'll use it to determine the frequency, the amplitude, the unscaled amplitude, and the final amplitude. We also have the second wave. It's also an array of three. We have the average, which will be calculated from the wave. And it's the value that we'll send to the PWM. It's the value that we'll write on the PWM pin. We have another one for the second function, since we are using two functions. We also need two pins. So we have pin 1, which is we're going to use pin 9. We have pin 2, and this is pin 10. Next, since we have a time varying function, we'll use a time variable. We'll calculate accordingly a percentage from it. So this is the time variable, and it's used to calculate the time within the sine functions. And the percentage is to calculate the percentage in these functions. Next, the result from the calculation will be stored in a variable called templitude. So we have templitude 1, and it's the resulting function with time. And we have templitude 2. Since Arduinos can't give a negative voltage, we're gonna offset our signal, and for that we'll use an offset variable. Since our output is between 0 and 5 volts, we're gonna offset to the middle, which is 2.5 volts. We will also scale our work between 0 and 5 volts. We'll scale the results between 0 and 5 volts, therefore we need two more variables. We'll use a resolution, which is the update speed, which is the speed at which our Arduino will refresh. We'll keep it low. And we'll also define pi, which is 3.1459. Let's tidy these a bit. Now, in our setup, we have the first wave, and wave 1 0, which is the frequency, we'll set it to 50 hertz, and this is the frequency. We also have the wave's amplitude. We'll set it to 2.5 volts with an offset. This will be fine. We'll do the same for the second wave. So this is wave 2. We'll also set up some Arduino parameters, starting with the timer for pins 9 and 10, and we'll add this piece of code. This will set timer 1B, which is responsible for pins 9 and 10, to almost 31 kilohertz. We'll also declare pin 1 and pin 2 as outputs. We're done with declaring variables, and we're done with our setup. It's time to start our loop. First of all, based on the time that we have, based on the Arduino's running time, we're going to calculate the percentage and accordingly calculate an amplitude in the sine functions. We're going to get the time based on the number of microseconds which the Arduino has been running for. So we're going to get the remainder of a division by 1 million. This will give us a six-digit figure. Accordingly, we'll calculate a percentage, and the percentage is dividing the time that we have by 1 million. We'll have, therefore, a number between 0 and 1. Afterward, we'll calculate a time amplitude, which we call templitude, for function 1, and this is templitude 1. And here we have a sine function, and it's the percentage times wave 1's frequency we will multiply it by 2 pi. So this is 2 pi f, and a percentage that's varying between 0 and 1. Therefore, this is varying between 0 and 2 pi. Yet, this is not enough. We want to raise it to the third power, since, again, we have here 5 sine t to the power 3. So this is power, and I'll put 3 here. This looks good enough, yet I won't multiply it by 5. Instead, I'll divide everything by 5, not to exceed 5 volts. So I'm going to divide this function by 5, and I'm going to divide the y by 5 as well. The sine function will give a value between minus 1 and 1. If I multiply it by the amplitude, it will vary between negative 2.5 and positive 2.5. And again, the Arduino can't give a negative voltage, therefore I'll offset it. So I have wave 1, 2, and it's templitude 1 multiplied by the amplitude that I have. And I'll add the offset. This way, my voltage will vary between 0 and 5 volts. So this was calculating the x function. We'll move to calculating the y. We'll do the same logic. And I've decided to divide by 5 again. So this will change from 4 to 0.8. This will change to 0.26. So this is templitude 2 equals 0.8 times cosine. And again, I'll take the percentage that I have. I'll multiply it by wave 2's frequency, which is also 50 hertz. And I'll multiply the whole thing by 2 pi. I don't have any powers here. I just need to pay attention to my parentheses. This is 1.3 divided by 5. And again here, I'll copy this. Yet this is 2t according to the function. So I'll multiply the whole thing by 2. And this is at 3t, so I'll multiply by 3. And I'll divide 0.2 by 5, and this is 40, so I'll multiply by 4. Again, I need to multiply this value, which is between negative 1 and 1, by its amplitude, by the amplitude that I want, and then offset it. So I'll type wave 2, 2 equals. I've obtained the desired voltages, yet I want to change them to PWM values, and therefore 0 volts will give me 0, and 5 volts would give me 255, since by default I'm working on 8 bits. And here I'll add a function, which is also not my work, and we'll use this function to change the voltages into 8-bit values. And here we have this mapf function, which will take a value, it will also take the minimum and maximum values, and we'll also give it the minimum and maximum output values. This is written outside the loop, just in case you have a problem. This is just scaling. We'll get back to the loop, and we'll have the average value, which we declared to write as PWM, and this is average one. It's mapping wave one's final amplitude to between 0 and 255. So we have wave one, two. The minimum output scale was already defined, and we're mapping it between 0 and 255 again because we're working on 8 bits. The same goes for average 2. I'll copy this function and use it for average 2. So I have to change this to average 2, and here I have to change this to wave 2. I'll write my PWM values to the analog pins, so I'll use analog write, and I can type 9 or pin 1, doesn't matter. And this is average 1, and this is the output voltage. In fact, it's the PWM result. I'll add a small delay. It's the resolution that I set before. It's just to give it time to set the voltage. We're ready to save our work, but here I forgot the 2. So let's add it. Now we're ready to verify our work. And if it's verified, we can upload it to the Arduino. This is the signal that we expect to see on channels 1 and channel 2 if everything works correctly, if we connect our Arduino's output to the oscilloscope. Yet, if we connect it, we'll see this square signal with a varying duty cycle. This is due to the nature of PWM. So, in fact, we're seeing the PWM signal. We're not seeing the signal that we intended to see. To solve that, we need to filter out the PWM from the signal. Therefore, we're going to filter out the high frequency components. In other words, we're integrating or averaging the signal that we have. So we need a low pass RC filter. We'll connect, first of all, our ground, our Arduino's ground, to the test board. We'll also take the output from pin 9 and connect it to the test board. The signal that we intend to take from pin 9 has frequency components at 50 and 150 Hz. Therefore, if I connect a 10 kilo ohm resistor with a 0.1 microfarads capacitor, I'll get a cutoff frequency at 160 Hz, and this is satisfactory for what we have. So I'll connect this resistor to pin 9. And in series with it, I'll connect the 0.1 microfarads capacitor. If you're using a polarized capacitor, be careful with the polarity. You have to connect the negative pin to the ground. Now, at the node that's common between the resistor and the capacitor, we'll connect channels 1 probe, and we'll connect channels 1 ground clip to the negative row on the breadboard. We'll apply the same logic for the other pin, for pin 10. So we'll take a wire from pin 10 to the test board, and there we have frequency components ranging between 50 and 200 Hz. And if I do some calculation, at 8 kilo ohms connected with 100 nanofarads, I'll obtain a cutoff frequency of 200 Hz, around 200 Hz. And therefore, I need the 8 kilo ohm resistor here. Yet it doesn't exist in the market. You can use a 7.5 or 8.2 kilo ohms instead. You'll connect it also in series with the capacitor, 100 nanofarads or 0.1 microfarads, it's the same. You'll connect channel 2 to the node that's common between the resistor and the capacitor. And again, the clip, the ground clip, will be connected to the ground row. At this point, if we test our circuit, we'll get the expected result.
So this is the X channel coming from pin 9. This is the Y channel from pin 10. And these are the two together. Now I want to put the oscilloscope in the XY mode. I usually access it using the dual button. It depends on the oscilloscope's model. So this is the XY mode. We can adjust the position and the volts per division. If the oscilloscope has the hold button, we can hold for a still image.